We'll start the preliminary test. We are taking the salt. You can see the texture of the salt. And then we can add a slight amount of water into it. Just rub it out. Dip your glass rod. And bring it nearer to your nose and smell it, whether it is giving a acetic acid, vinegar-like smell or not. So this is being done. Now dry heating test. So we'll take a slight amount of salt in a dry test tube and we'll heat it up. And while heating, please take care that your test tube should not be in much contact of the flame. Otherwise, there's a chances of explosion. So while heating it up, you can bring the moist litmus paper over the mouth of the test tube. And if it turns red, that shows the presence of acid in this. Acetic acid is an organic acid, so that's a weak acid. So you can see the coloration of a litmus paper. To undergo the indicatory test now, so this is concentrated sulfuric acid. I'm going to pour a slight amount of concentrated sulfuric acid in our salt. Take care while heating it up. And while heating, it will start evolving acetic acid vapors. And we can see the presence of acetic acid vapors with the help of a blue litmus paper. So, we have a blue litmus paper, moist blue litmus paper with us. Let's see whether it's showing any change or not. You can see the blue litmus paper turned red. That shows the acetic vapors emerged. So we are moving towards the confirmatory test of an acetate ion. So this is the first is oxalic acid test. We take a slight amount of our salt and then same amount of, so we'll take a same amount of an oxalic acid and we'll have a drop of water in it, that is distilled water, and then we'll make a paste with the help of a glass rod. And then, dipping the glass rod in a paste, you can just have a smell of it. It is having a strong smell of vinegar that shows the presence of an acetate ion. Okay. So, the next test is ferric chloride test. We have taken aqueous ferric chloride solution. We'll take a slight amount of this and then we'll neutralize it. And neutralize it with the help of ammonium hydroxide, the base. Ferric chloride is a Lewis acid. So it will be neutralized by ammonium hydroxide and it will create a brown precipitate. Brown precipitate in this manner. So that means it has been neutralized now. We'll take a salt and then we'll add slight amount of water in this. So it forms an aqueous solution. And then after mixing it well, you have to add neutral ferric chloride into it. Gives a brown precipitated solution which you have to filter. So the funnel with the filter paper, filter it up. Stop. We'll take one part of that filtrate. This is the filtrate which we obtained. We'll take one part and we will add dilute hydrochloric acid into this. So if the color disappears, it shows the presence of acetate ion. See. We'll take the second part, add a slight amount of water in it. and then we'll start boiling it up. On boiling, it should give a brown precipitate. So if it forms a brown precipitate, that shows the presence of an acetate ion. So you can see the presence of a brown precipitate, and that shows the presence of an acetate ion in the salt. Okay, so we are moving towards the confirmatory test of our lead ion. Salt plus water. Prepare an aqueous solution. And then the group reagent, because it is a group first cation, so the group reagent is dilute hydrochloric acid. So when you add the group reagent, you can see precipitation formation. See. That confirms the presence of a group first cation, that is lead ion. It sediments easily when you dip it in a cold water and keep it for some time. So I have divided it into two parts, and to first part I'll add potassium chromate, which make it turn yellow, dark yellow golden coloration. That's lead chromate formation. When you mix it well, you'll get the whole solution in the same color. Then to the second part, I can add slight amount of potassium iodide. And potassium iodide turns the whole solution light yellow. And this is a reliable test, because you can see potassium iodide is colorless in nature. So when it came in contact with the solution, it turned it yellow. So you can see the color difference now. One, it's a dark orange coloration. And the second one, that is of potassium iodide, is a light yellow coloration. So this is the confirmatory test for lead ion, the formation of a lead chromate as well as lead iodide. Reaction equations related to our test, analysis of the lead ion. So we were having lead acetate with us, and we added hydrochloric acid into it. So white precipitate formation took place, and that's lead chloride. Then we undergone confirmatory test of lead ion, and we have undergone potassium iodide test. And in that case, lead chloride, that means a white precipitate which has been subdivided into two parts. In the first part, we added potassium iodide, and it gave yellow precipitate of lead iodide. The second test was potassium chromate test, where the lead chloride, the second part of the white precipitate, is being treated with potassium chromate. It forms lead chromate, that was orange yellow precipitate. Then indicatory test, concentrated sulfuric acid test. We took our salt and we treated it with concentrated sulfuric acid, that gives acetic acid vapors. And we dipped the blue litmus paper and brought it towards the mouth of the test tube, and it turned red. That was because of those vapors. Oxalic acid test. Formula of an oxalic acid. Treated with our salt. Formation of a vinegar-like smell vapors. That is acetic acid vapors. The two equations over here. Uske baad mein the remaining equations. Ester test. Lead acetate. Concentrated sulfuric acid. Turns into lead sulfate and it evolves acetic acid, and that acetic acid will be treated with ethyl alcohol in order to give ethyl acetate, that's ester, which is having a fruity smell. So our last test is ferric chloride test. We have taken aqueous solution of our salt. We treated it with neutral ferric chloride, and how to utilize the ferric chloride solution. We have an aqueous solution of our ferric chloride in our laboratory. We'll add ammonium hydroxide, that's the base. Ferric chloride is a Lewis acid, so it will be neutralized with the help of ammonium hydroxide, and it gives a brown precipitate. That brown precipitate shows neutralization reaction. So that neutral ferric chloride is being added to the aqueous solution of the salt, and then it is being converted into ferric acetate. That ferric acetate has undergone two reactions, and out of that one reaction was when it is being added with water and boiled, it forms a reddish brown precipitate, and that is this complex. Result is acetic radical, that was the anionic part was acetate ion, basic radical lead ion.